First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me and giving me this chance. Okay, so the title of my talk is Random Matrix Theory and Infinite Dimensional Stochastic Differential Equations. I mean, I will talk about a very natural time evolution of infinitely many particles related to random matrix, say, sine beta, Airy, Genevieve, Bessel, and so on. And actually, I will explain a general theory, but its contents can be applied to many, many concrete examples interacting with logarithmic interactions. So here is a subtitle. So my subtitle is Algebraic, Geometric, and Probabilistic Method on Infinite Particle Systems. I mean, okay, so my objective is infinite many particles. So let me for sure that explain what is infinite many particles. Yes, this is it. As you see, this infinite many particle system is, in some sense, the standard ones, the typical one. Left-hand side is a Poisson point process in the plane, whose intensity is a Lebesgue measure. So as you know, this is a standard point process. And you see, they are really translation invariant, rotation invariant. It has many, many nice invariants and very independent. So it is very complicated. But this is the point process. So it's played a role like something like Brownian motion and the Lebesgue measure and simple random walk and so on. On the other hand, right-hand side is, this is also very standard point process called Genevieve. And as you see, this is certainly has a nice, invariance. But it has certainly some, you see, well-organized randomness. This is because they interact through logarithmic potentials. And as you see, this is coming from a Genevieve point random matrices, Genevieve ensembles. And this is actually the standard one. And maybe you learn from the talk of Kiyu. I mean, maybe he talked about Genevieve as examples, yes. So this is a very important example. This is the only one unique example of infinite many particle systems with logarithmic potential in more than one dimension at the present. Okay, these are my target. But I would like to talk about the stochastic dynamics of these infinite many particles. So one example is the following. I mean, I would like to show simulation to get ideas. Here it is. So this is a simulation of Genevieve interacting with Brownian motion. If there is no interactions, then each particle moves something like Brownian motion. But each particle has an interaction, logarithmic interaction, repulsive, very strong repulsive force, so the movement is really suppressed. Okay, so this is a typical example I would like to think about it. So how to construct such an infinite many particle system dynamics as a solution of infinite dimensional stochastic differential equation? That is my interest. And actually, the property of these dynamics are very different from the standard Brownian motions. Okay, so I hope you can get some intuition about what I'm going to talk about, right? Any questions? Pardon? Yeah?
Motion of every particle is local.
Yes. Actually, later I will explain. This is a dynamical rigidity, what I have proved. It's a very special property. Yes. Okay. Going back to the original talk, yes. So I would simply skip that. So it is an example of this particle system is an example of Gaussian random matrices, say GUE or GSE or GOE or something like that. And also, of course, Genevieve point process is related to the Genevieve non-Hermitian random Gaussian matrices. Okay. I like to skip this in case. So now let us consider semicircle law. So I start with law of large numbers. Yes? I mean, let us recall the Wigner's semicircle law. The distribution of eigenvalues of the GOE or GUE or GSE around the matrices are given by this formula. It's a very well-known fact. Here, beta takes value of 1 or 2 or 4. It's a very explicit calculation, change of coordinate. You have this one. Yes. This is the starting point of everything. Now, then let us consider a law of large numbers of these things. So, okay, sorry. This xi is the eigenvalue of random matrices. Yes, and I put some labels. So you have distributions. Now let us start to think of just as this is a particles. Then we consider the distribution of the empirical distribution of these particles, say 1 over n, sum of the delta xi over square root of n. Square root of n is just for scaling. Okay. Then take n going to infinity. Then this is certainly a probability measure on the real line, and it's combined to the semicircle law. I mean, celebrated Wigner's semicircle law. Yeah? And you see, the limit semicircle law is non-random. So in this sense, this is the law of large numbers in random matrix theory. Now, once we have a law of large number, then we next want to have a central limit theory, change the scaling. Then we have, okay, so for theta, this is a macro scale, so let's take some point theta here. Then we consider rescaling here. This is a different scaling. Then the distribution becomes something like this one. This term doesn't change because there is a new normalization here, but this term becomes something like this one. So this is a very simple calculations. Then what is known is the Dyson proof that this probability measure, it's a probability measure of point process combined to the mu beta theta weakly in the space of point processes. Here, this point process is a so-called sine beta point process. I mean, it is a determinantal point process with kernel here. Theta appears here. But anyway, it is just essentially this is just a sine 2 point process, yeah? Okay, just for beta equal 4. Yeah, not the determinant, Fatian, yes. But the other is okay. Yeah, Fatian is, yes, okay, let us regard Fatian is the determinant. Very small difference. Okay, any questions? Anyway, the point is, you see, this is the central limit theory. So we expect universality. And recently, many, many, many active mathematicians say Tao, Yao, Peche, Benaruz, and many people prove the universality at this level. If one changes the Gaussian unitary ensemble, something like a Wigner matrix, or more general coefficients. Anyway, we have such universality. I mean, static universality, yeah? No. Yao proved that. Yao proved that.
You proved?
Yao. H-T-Yao. They are, okay, so recently, Yao and Burgen, I don't pronounce. And prove that, I mean, as you can see, papers, it's very mild content, it's combined to the UC weekly.
So general
vector. Universality. In some sense, they serve weak universality conjecture. Dyson proved that it's, in some sense, convergence of the point, I mean, correlation function, it's in some sense strong. Anyway, now it's a very, very rapidly proceeded. Okay. Now, but, okay, so you see, these are all geometric problems, yeah? So let us recall that probability theory starts from central limit theorem, law of large number, then it's that time evolution, that is the invariance, Donskoy's invariance principle. So what I would like to talk about is the level of invariance principle, dynamical problem, yes? Any questions? Now, anyway, let us consider associate any particle system for given any particle system. So for the given GUE, the natural any particle system is this given by this stochastic potential equation. Okay, there is actually, in case of beta equal 2, there is another device due to, say, Dyson, but put some Brownian motion in the material, random matrix, something like that. But I don't use it. But more general and natural interpretation, we have this stochastic variation education. The correspondence is very simple. Let me simply explain. It is a general frame. Let us consider, so you can space, have a measure M, then consider distorted, so called distorted. I hope that everybody agreed with this is natural, because if one take M is just a Lebesgue measure, then associate diffusion process is a Brownian motion. Right. In general, for given M, so there is a, okay, so such a map is, it's a space of measure to the, some bilinear, space of bilinear form, then it becomes a space of diffusions, anyway. So it's a Dirichlet theorem. And in general, for given measure M, say MX, then associate SD is given by Brownian motion plus logarithmic derivative. So if one can calculate logarithmic derivative, then you have a natural SD and natural dynamics. So because very simple calculation, you have FD equals some minus. So from this generator, you have a stochastic differential equation anyway. Now, using this calculation, applying to the previous density, you have this SDE. So please note that you have here is a 2 over beta here. This is not zero for if theta is not zero, yes? Because if theta is here, that is vanished. Here, that is not vanished. Then let us consider take n to the infinity. And what we have proved is the following. Dynamical sum dynamic limit. So the limit stochastic differential equation, you may think this one. It's a very informal limit of the previous one. But this is not correct answer. Because the correct answer is Dyson interacting Brownian motion, this one. So this term is always zero in the limit. So there is a very mysterious fact is that there is some SD gap occurs. In this sense, the taking limiting procedure is a very sensitive problem. So anyway, we have with Kawamoto that F beta equal 2, it's combined to the solution combined to this one, not to this one. Okay, so this is the first, convergence theorem, a kind of invariance principle. Yes. So this is the scale, okay. The
very intuitive explanation is the following. This part of the particle is still something. But I just canceled theta beta, so you have it.
Okay, anyway, any questions? Okay, now this is a bulk scaling. So I like to next consider the soft edge scaling.
It is a scaling of the, say, I like to
choose
this. And the scaling is very different from the bulk scaling.
So the correct scaling for the soft edge is this one. Then you have, the limit, this random point, point process combined to the early point process, so which is this one, which is, again, determinantal point process for beta equal 2, given by this determinant, this kernel. This is a very well-known fact. And of course, for beta equal 1 and 4, there is another Parfian point process, yes. Nowadays, for general beta, there is some convergence. It's known due to the Virac and many other people, so not universality, but okay, anyway, in this case, very specially, we have a good control of this. Now, let us consider the associate dynamical problem. Well, first of all, let us consider the n-particle dynamics. Now, the easy to, because from this expression, I can easily calculate the n-dimensional n-particle SD. The answer is, you see, this one. So interaction term, this term is different, the same as before. But from this term, we have these new Dirichlet term. Okay, this term will be no problem because it should be vanished at infinity. But in this case, from this scaling, we have some n third term which combines the plus infinity as it is. But still, there's very fantastic cancellation because of this one and this one, and so the limit infinite dimensional SD is as follows. This is a very subtle calculation, but we can carry out it. Yes? The limit SD is, this is any particle SD. Let us take a limit. There are very fantastic cancellation between this term and this term. Then we have an interaction term and this term. This function is something like this one. You see, this is very natural, such a, because the limit function is the descaling of this. New function here. So it's a very natural idea to have this SD. And so again, we have proved the convergence of this stochastic dynamics. Okay, any questions? Now I proceed. Okay, now main part. Okay, so these are just an application of our general theory or examples. So I like to, the main topic of today is I would like to explain the general theory behind to obtaining such a result. So it's a theory of infinite dimensional stochastic differential equation. And so the theory consists of three parts. Step one is construction of solution of invariantly dimensional stochastic differential equations So this is a geometric approach. And the second step is, in some sense, this is so-called weak solutions. And I cannot prove the uniqueness of solution for this step. In the next step, I prove that it's certainly a strong solution in the sense that it's a function of Brownian motion, given Brownian motion, and also it is certainly unique. So it's what I call schema and tail method. I will explain. The final step, okay, in step two, I prove that the uniqueness of solution of stochastic differential equation reduces to the tail triviality of path space of the solutions. Then in the final step, such a tail triviality just comes from the tail triviality of point process. Okay, so that is the punchline of my talk. Now, I like to explain each steps. Now, okay, so this is the general theory, can be applied to all real class potentials, and also many, you see, logarithmic potentials. So let us consider the very general situation. Here is this is the, n is natural number, so it means this is infinite dimensional SDE. And this is the Martingale term, okay, and this is the Dirac term. And this is the labeled dynamics. This is a labeled particle, x1, x2, x3, dot, dot, dot. So RD to the n, natural number valued. And I consider a diamond I is all particle other than I. I remove just I particle here. So I diamond is something vacant, yes? Now, I assume that this, of course, this is matrices and vectors. And so, anyway, the usual assumption. But the most examples, and all our example is sigma is just a unit vector, and this comes from the interaction potential psi, say logarithmic potential, or Reynolds-Jones potential, and so on, something like that. That is the setup. Now, I would like to, so this type of SD initiated by Richard Lang, maybe, in the later of 70s. Around the 70s, the theory of Gibbs measure ideas established by Ranford Ruel, something like that. Now, dynamic part is takes 10 years. But anyway, they solved this as the infinite dimensional SE has a unique solutions for given initial suitable initial distribution with smooth C0 slip interaction potentials. And, I would like to develop a method applicable to the long range potential, something like Reynolds-Jones and Ruiz, and also but these are easy to apply because this is a real class. And also, another example is Dyson model and ARE, interacting brain emotion. As I explained before, this is related to ARE point process, and also a Bessel point process, Bessel interacting brain emotion. This comes the Bessel term, yes? Okay. So in all interaction is a two-dimensional Coulomb potential. Okay. And it is well known that sign related to bulk, air is soft edge, the Bessel is hard edge. Anyway, it depends on model, but. And actually, now universality proved for this model statically at the level of geometric due to, say, Yao, Tao, and many others. But you see, dynamical universality is not so much. I mean, only one example is our result. Anyway, it's now began to start with this kind of dynamical problem. Now, okay, another very important example is a two-dimensional object. It's a Geneva interacting brain emotion. Let us consider two different SDE in two dimension two. As you see, I think that these two infinite dimensional SDE is certainly a different equation, because this is completely translation invariant SDE, but the second one is Ornstein-Uhlenbeck term. It's attracted to the origin. But something very nice is that this dynamics has a rigidity, and it has the same unique strong solution for almost sure starting point with respect to Geneva. That's one of the key points. Okay, you see, different SD has the same unique strong solutions. This never happened for the rare class usual interaction potentials. It is specific. It's a result of the geometric rigidity of Geneva. Right. Okay, and another dynamical rigidity is the following. I have proved that let us tag each particle xi, and let us consider here Brownian scaling, diffusive scaling. Usually, under such a scaling, the particle combines to the Brownian motion, non-degenerate Brownian motion, as far as the interaction is translation invariant. This is really the case for the all real class potential more than one dimension, say hard core potential and real class or something like that. But in case of, you see, logarithmic potential for beta equal to 2, it's certainly degenerate. It means because of the, let us recall the simulations, because all particles have a very strong repulsion, so the movement is surely suppressed. Then it becomes some diffusion. It's an intuitive plan. The pro is there for that anyway. It's a one spin off my result. Now, okay. So let us return to the general theory. I consider ISD with symmetry. I mean, so let us some self S be a usual configuration space as usual, and I consider this SD. This is the same SD, but I write down it differently because this is a configuration valued process here, something like that. Because the previous SD has a symmetry, so this is certainly equivalent in this SD. So I often call it such a dynamics, unraveled dynamics. Anyway. Now, the step one, key point of step one is the KSI Gibbs property, what I call. I mean, I introduce the two notions to solve this problem. One is the KSI Gibbsian, it's a existence local density. Another one is the logarithmic derivative. I will explain. So outline of the proof is the following. Once we have a point process, then we have a natural Dirichlet home, as I explained for finite dimensional case. And then we have an unraveled diffusion from this Dirichlet home. Then we have a labeled dynamics from this one, because all particles never hit each other, I assume this one, easy to check this one. Then we have a solution with SD representations. Okay, now that's the outline of the proof, and I explain much more about it. 15 minutes. Now, SRB is a ball with a radius R, and this is a usual, you see, regular conditional probability conditioned outside here. Then, so let us consider Hamiltonian inside SR. Phi and psi is the potential, the free potential and interaction potential. I said a point process is phi psi KSI Gibbs if the measure inside is controlled by from above, from below, with some inside Hamiltonian. Note that there's no interaction between inside and outside for the Hamiltonian. This constant may depend on EM, R, C. It's a very mild assumption, but it is enough for my purpose. So usual case, in case of Gibbs measure, we assume that it satisfies DL allocation. It is a equation of such equality. Here is the interaction between inside and outside. But in case of logarithmic potential, these terms always diverge. So I have to define new notion of something like this one. Such an inequality is enough for us. Okay, so, and another second object, okay. Once you have a KSI Gibbs measure, so, and these potentials are, say, upper semi-continuous, then associated Dirichlet home is closable, so we have a nice semi-group. Moreover, if K correlation function of point process are locally bounded, then it is the associated diffusion process exists. It's a very, perfectly satisfactory construction of diffusion associated with a given point process. Okay, now, of course, the associated Dirichlet home is this one, and this is a standard square field on the space of configurations. Now, so In sum up, I have this result, I mean, starting from 1960s, ended 13, so it's a very, you see, general theory and can be applied to many different situations, so, now, but this is not expression, I have no expression of SDE at this level, at this point. So next, I like to express it, representation, I want representation of dynamics in terms of stochastic differential equations. For that, so I would like to assume each particle never collide each other, but this is easy to check because of the capacity. And each target particle never explode, this is again easy to check for the current situation because of Lyon chain decomposition. Then once you have these things, then you can initially label the dynamic, label the particle, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then each label of the particle never collide. It means that it keeps the label forever. It means we have a label, you have a label of dynamics. So you have a label of dynamics, then rest is a representation of the label of dynamics. Yes? Now, in order to get SDE, let us introduce logarithmic derivative. You see, this is not a logarithmic derivative of point process, but it's a logarithmic derivative of the one Campbell measure. That is the key point. Because I consider that one particle and consider the effect of other particles, so one Campbell measure is very natural. So the definition of one Campbell measure is this one. This is a one correlation function, and this is a reduced particle measure condition at EX, as usual. Then I define logarithmic derivative of something like this one. So this is, I define it by weak in distributional sense. In principle, intuitively, what I defined is this is a function of X and configuration, so nabla in X and of log of mu sub 1. This is a very, you see, loose expression, but it is correct. So definition is it is not so obvious, but I check it. Of course, this is a very important problem. I mean, of course. Okay, now periodic point process never had logarithmic derivative. It became a delta function, yeah? But fortunately, Genebo, Bessel, Sine Beta, Airy has a logarithmic derivative, what I have proved, at least for beta equal 2. Okay, I will explain. But it's a maybe I don't have time, so I will explain later because I don't plan to. Yes, I have some. Of course, I have some nice sufficient condition of these things, and I applied it. I mean, logarithmic interaction, random matrix theories. In case of usual red plus potential, this is trivial, right? This is trivial. But in case of logarithmic potential, it is never trivial. It depends on, my proof very much depends on each model, each point process. It depends on the property of orthogonal polynomial, some very fine estimate, something like that. Or rigidity of point process, small variance process, something like that. It comes from the geometry of point process, yes. Okay, but anyway, so it is a very nice situation. So we have to do a lot of things to carry out this for the log potentials. Now, okay, now I want to say, in subtitle I say geometric method. So let us consider geometric differential equation. It's a differential equation for this logarithmic derivative. Once you have solved this one, then you have a solution with this SDE. This is the solution of this equation. Here. So this is the second theorem. This is again very universal result. What I need is the only existence of logarithmic derivative. Then you have a solution of weak solution of infinite dimensional stochastic differential equations. Okay. Any questions? Or? Right. Now, I don't have time. I mean, it's far enough. So, okay, now I have several very different key points for these things. So one is the following. I introduced a scheme of infinite dimensional stochastic differential equation. I said,
10 minutes.
I have 10 minutes. More than 10 minutes. 10. Yeah? No, more, okay. 10 minutes left. Okay, I see. Okay, now, instead of consider infinite many differential equations, so I have there is a convergence, but this let us consider the SD with respect to Campbell measures. Then this new SD diffusion has consistency, then associated diffusion is given by the same diffusion. So it has a consistency. So in order to reduce these things, from this one, I have this equation. The key point is the following. Originally, I had solved SD in this very huge infinite dimension space, RD to the natural numbers. But instead of I introduce schemes, scheme means that following. This is the configuration space, and I have a diffusion given by Dirichlet-Ohm, and one labeled and configuration space, that. All these are infinitely dimensional space, but all these are very small infinite dimension. Then easy to treat. So I consider the solution, I consider sequence of solution in this space, and putting it together, they are consistent. We have a solution in this huge space. That is one of the key idea I frequently use. Okay, now step two. How strong solution and pathwise uniqueness. In a word, a single infinite dimension is equivalent to the scheme of finite dimensional stochastic financial equations. I have this another key point. This method is very, I believe, robust and applied to many different things. So this is again general theory. I consider a sequence of infinite dimensional SDEs. And I suppose that this has a weak solution. I don't assume the uniqueness, but generally I have a solution. But it is okay in the first step. And secondly, I consider let X be a solution of previous ISD, then I consider again the SDEs. And this solution regard as a coefficient, yes? So I consider new SD, but X is not a solution. This is a part of coefficient. The new SD treat this Y, okay? I treat again, SDE. Then we have, these are time inhomogeneous finite dimension SDE, so you have, it has a unique strong solution. But because of the uniqueness, these new solution becomes the original solution because of the uniqueness. So what I'm doing the following. First, we have a solve X as a weak level. Next, consider step one, we have a unique Y1. Step two, we have a unique Y1, Y2. Step three, Y3. Step four, Y4, that. But you see, all these scheme of finite dimension SE has a unique strong solution. It becomes X itself. This is a very tricky part of this one. So now, there I have, well, where it is, okay. So we have, now using this one, finally I show that, the limit is, in some sense, a function of the tail sigma field of original X because of the constructions. So the problem is how to prove the triviality of, if one can prove that this is a, original solution, but more than M labels, M1, M plus 1, M plus 2, that. This is the tail part with respect to label. And if one can prove this part is trivial, then the new solution Y is a function of the starting point and the Brownian motion and this part. But if it is trivial, it means it's a unique strong solution because of the tail triviality implies the uniqueness of the solution. So this is my key point of the question. But you may think that still, these are very huge sigma field. So how to prove such a triviality of the huge pass level sigma field? That is a very big problem. But in order to prove this, I consider the following. In a word, in order to prove the tail triviality of pass space, I assume that originally reversible measure mu is tail trivial and it is reversible. In some sense, abstract continuity condition. Let us assume that unravel solution is reversible. It is okay in current situation. And finally, I assume this is not so fluctuating. It is easy to check. Under all conditions, especially the deletability of the point process, P3 at the deletability of path space fold. It means that we have a unique strong solution. You see, deletability of such a huge space reduces to the deletability of the point process. It is easy to, something easy to check. And fortunately, you see, well, first of all case I use measure have a tail decomposition. So I can always apply this theorem to the usual case I give the measure, or a real class gives the measure, something like that, because by using this tail decomposition. But the meaning of a unique that a little bit reduced, but it is okay. I'm very much satisfied with this. And moreover, very fortunately, sine 2, ARE 2, Bessel 2, and the Geneva point process are all tail trivial. More precisely, I have proved that with my OSADA, and also independently we have proved that all determinant point process on contingent spaces are tail trivial. So it is a very satisfactory result. In your case, okay, maybe not so precisely. Okay, in my result, I mean, all determinant measure tail trivial. I mean, different proof, I think. I mean, I have some. Okay, anyway, it's another story. It's okay, so now the final step. I should comment algebraic method. I never says not so much think about algebraic. I mean, these are now explanation about it. Okay, for 2 minutes. Okay, now this is the last slide. Now,
3 minutes.
Now, okay, maybe I just want to really how to prove the tail triviality is the following. Okay, so start from the point process. Once we have this one, then we have a tail triviality of the configuration valued path space. Tilde means the cylindrical. It's a rather the step by step. The next step, I prove the cylindrical and labeled path space. It's a rather huge space, and the final step, it's a non, I remove cylindrical, it's a original path space. It's a very, 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 very subtle and difficult proof, I think. But it's just a major theory, but very difficult proof, I think. Anyway, I prove it. Now, final slide, 2 minutes. Okay, so algebraic. You see, determinant point process has a very something miracle, especially in one-dimensional case. So let us consider in one dimension. So I mean sine 2, RE 2, Bessel 2. It's a very standard class. I mean, typical 3 examples. Now, in case, I mean, in some sense, these models are solvable models. You have a very algebraic construction of dynamics. Maybe it starts from Johansson and completed by Kattori Tanamura that. Okay, so for example, they have some, they prove that there is some stochastic process whose Laplace transform given by Fred Holm determinant like this one. So, okay, this is the early case, but there is some another time-dependent time and kernels here for the sine or Bessel is also like this one. So anyway, you have a very concrete representation of the kernel, so you can calculate moment easily. Not easily, but anyway, you can do that. Yes, in principle. And so we have Osada Tanemura, and also recently Osada Kawamoto proved that. Okay, so you see, the construction very different from original, my construction due to Dirichlet theory of stochastic analysis. It's just a calculation. And it is not trivial for such a calculation that they are Markovian. It is highly non-trivial. But finally, we prove that these two constructions give the same solution, same dynamics, same stochastic dynamics, because of the thanks to the uniqueness theorem. You see, so it is very, myself, I very much like this result, because from the algebraic construction, you have a quantitative information. And from probabilistic analytic construction, you have, qualitative information, such as each trajectory, each path continuous, each path never hit each other, or some fluctuation or something like that. We can easily see these things because of stochastic analysis. But it is very hard from the algebraic, algebraic calculation. But anyway, these two are very different. It's coming together. It's like some bridge here. So it's very nice. Okay, so what I want. I'd like to stop here.